Guess who's back, back, back again, again. Beanie's back, back. Tell your friend, friend. Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Hope you guys are doing well. Can I just say, I don't think I've ever been this excited to make this video. This is such a massive, massive, massive topic and something that I want to forever preach. Something that I wish was preached to me. Something I wish to preach to my daughters, and let's get into it. I just want to say this. If you want to know what your self-worth is like, look at all the things you are tolerating in your life right now. This will show you what you think your value is. This will show you what your worth is, and this will show how you are undervaluing yourself. So my question to you today is, what are you tolerating? What upsets you, but you think you have to shut your mouth and take it? What are the words you are eating instead of saying? What is a foot that you're tapping instead of putting it down? What are the things that you dislike about your life right now that you have given up, resolved to just be quiet about it, to just take it? What are the expectations that you've had yet have had to lower in order to make others around you feel comfortable? We can look at your relationships and we can look at your dating. For me, these two areas is what really shows how you value or do not value yourself. What are you allowing the person you are in a relationship with to do that you are not speaking up about because you don't want to ruffle feathers, because you don't want that person to get angry, because you don't want that person to get upset, because you don't want that person to leave you? What are the things you are tolerating in your relationships? Is it cheating? Is it disrespect? Is it emotional abuse? Is it physical abuse? Is it not getting married? Is it not having children when you want them? Is it having children when you don't want them? What are you settling for in your relationships? What are you biting your tongue about in your relationships? What are you saying, oh well, actually I don't want it, when you do want it, but you've had to lower your expectation because you don't believe you're gonna get it, because you don't believe you're worth it? What are you tolerating during dating? He calls you whenever he wants to. When he calls, you jump. You ask him for honesty, but he only gives you lies. But guess what? No one can make you feel this small if you don't already feel this small. And it's like, what came first, the chicken or the egg? Did the lack of self-esteem come first, or you tolerating low down dirty behavior? Because a person will only treat you how you allow them to treat you. If you never create a boundary that says stop, but you just lay down and take it, you're just a doormat. Do you know why? Because you don't think you're valuable. No matter how much you've convinced yourself, I'm valuable, told yourself 10 times in the mirror every single day for 365 days, I'm valuable, you don't believe it. And until you believe it, until you believe you're valuable, you'll keep reducing your value. Even though God says your value is here, you're worth more than rubies, you're gorgeous, you're lovable, you're kind, you're caring. God has set your value this high, but you keep accepting here. Do you know why? Because you believe this is what you deserve. So people can tell you you're high value, you deserve this, you deserve that, you deserve this, you deserve this. Don't tolerate that. Do you know why you keep going back to your ex? Because your value is here. And I want you to get to here. When you truly believe you're valuable, you're worth being treated correctly, right, honest, you deserve loyalty, commitment, not see how it goes or go with the flow, commitment. And as we're talking about relationships, the highest price a man can put on you is your hand in marriage. Oh, but I don't want to be married. Is that true? Or is that something that you have settled for? Did you once want to get married? Did you once have this dream of being someone's wife, building a home together, having children, being a stable home? Did you once have that dream? But because you were someone that doesn't think that you're worth giving that to, you've lowered your expectation. Why? So you're not disappointed, because there's nothing worse than being disappointed and feeling like you can't do anything about it. But you can do something about it. And I'm telling you, you can do something about it. You can say, no, I'm not going to tolerate this behavior. No, I won't stay here. When you communicate it to the person that you love, this is what I want, this is what I desire, and the person says, well, I'm not going to give you what you desire, I can't give you right now what it is that you want, you have a choice. stay or leave. And you know what keeps us staying? Lack of value. And the more you stay is the more that person devalues you. Because if you don't know what you're worth, you think you're garbage, the person's gonna treat you like garbage. They're gonna treat you like you don't mean anything. And you're going to accept it because you believe it yourself. And so we're stuck in this cycle from generation to generation to generation of not knowing our worth and our value. How long? How long will you stay in that job or that career receiving money? You believe, truly, hand on heart, that you're doing more work for that company than what they're paying you for. You're adding more value to that company, to that business, than what you're getting back. I ask again, what are you tolerating? How much are you worth? And you will always know when you're devaluing yourself because it doesn't feel good to your soul. You truly feel like you've sold yourself cheap. You truly feel that you've lowered your standards, your expectations. And a standard is not a bad thing to have. A standard communicates what it is that you need to feel safe in your work, in your relationship, in your family, in your friendships. When you raise a standard, you're telling people who you are. When you don't raise a standard, they are left to value you at any price. And this is why it's important to have parents that validate you. If you don't, there will be left a void, a chasm for others to tell you how much you are worth. For people that dislike you, for people that don't love you, to tell you what you are worth. Or even worse, for you to make up in your mind a value that is less than who you are. So when your value is less than who you are, you will accept anything that's on that standard. So look around at your life. What are you tolerating? That will show you how you feel about yourself. And only one person can give us value, and that's God. Our parents, they reinforce that value to us. They're not lying to you when they say that you're valuable, you're worth something, that you deserve good things in your life. They're not lying to you. That's a standard. Parents are there to reinforce that standard. But if you don't know, what are you supposed to do? And when we talk about family and friends, what are you tolerating in those relationships? What boundaries are you allowing people to cross with you? Time and time and time and time and time again, boundaries show your value to others. Standards show your value to others. And I'll use the car as an analogy again. If I keep my car inside prestige, I've set a standard. No one eats in my car. And you can come in my car and see for yourself that there's a standard here. If you have no standard and your car reflects that, you do what you want. There's mess everywhere. When others come into your car, when they come into your life and they don't see any standards, they'll treat you how you treat yourself. And that's a fact. Boundaries keep you safe. And a lot of issues that we have in relationship especially is a boundary issue. You don't set boundaries because you don't want to be rejected. Because what if you set a boundary and someone says, oh well, forget you then, you're going to be crushed because you don't have any value. When someone walks into the Louis Vuitton store and tries to bargain with the sales assistant and they say, no, the bag costs 8,000, and you start saying, oh, I ain't paying 8,000, I'll give you 2,000, and the cashier says, no, that's not what it's worth. I don't care what it's worth, I've got this, and if you don't, security, get this fool out of here. You'll be caught in security because that person done lost their mind. The bag costs what it costs, and I'm not desperate for you to buy it. That's my boundary. That's where I stop. Where do you stop? What boundary have you set for your life? And I repeat again, the reason why we don't set boundaries is because we don't want to be rejected. I'd rather have some love than no love at all. I've been there. I work through it every day. So desperate to be loved. Throw away our boundaries because I'd rather have 5 people love me incorrectly than nobody love me at all. And until you value yourself, until you love yourself, nobody's love will be enough. You could have 1 million people following you, calling your name, saying how wonderful you are. It's not going to fill the void. It's never going to fill the void. You could get married. You could have a husband, a bunch of children, and still not feel value. And you'll put the pressure on your husband. You'll put the pressure on your children to love you more than you love yourself. When you don't love yourself, you're a bottomless pit. Your appetite cannot be satisfied because the love at the foundation, above the foundation of God, the self-love, it's not there. It falls. People are pouring in, I love you so much. The next day, what's wrong? Why are you acting like that? Well, I don't feel loved. I told you yesterday. Well, tell me again, your bottom is falling out. You don't have a grounding. So one thing I will say to encourage you this year, this moment, to know your value, know what you're worth. Don't tolerate less. Speak up for yourself. But you can only speak up for yourself when you've reinforced your value, when you know how much you're worth, and you refuse to settle for less. I'd rather be by myself than be treated like I'm worth nothing. Because when you have self-worth, when you value yourself, nobody can take it away from you. No one can take my value away. I have value. No one can take it away. No one can add to it either. I cost what I cost. Period. And I said what I said. Goodbye.